In India, though the production of mulberry sericulture is more in comparison with non-mulberry silk output, one cannot ignore the contribution of non-mulberry sericulture sector, which is earning a considerable foreign exchange besides providing gainful employment to millions of tribal folk and other weaker sections of the society. Non-mulberry silk represents a unique and romantic past of Indian history. In fact, millenniums before the utility of mulberry silkworm was discovered. Northeastern states of India are the only region in the world where all the four types of non-mulberry sericulture activities are practiced. These areas have good number of required food plants and potential for the growth of non-mulberry sericulture. Non-mulberry sericulture and weaving are part of the cultural ethos of the northeastern states people. Non-mulberry sericulture should be encouraged to open up new vistas of technology to make it sustainable to fetch prosperity at all levels. It can be accommodated to exploit forest and wasteland based industry for employment generation, ecological improvement and invigorating the rural economy. The role of non-mulberry sector in Indian agriculture and industrial development is noteworthy. It contributes the main raw material required for cottage industry. In addition, the export of non-mulberry silk goods brings considerable amount of foreign exchange. Hence, there is a vast scope for expansion of non-mulberry silk industry for generating self-employment for millions of tribals and maximizing non-mulberry silk production, which can generate impressive foreign exchange returns by export of silk goods. The hairy silkworm rearing is one of the important activities in the rural India, especially in northeastern states and parts of Bihar and Orissa states. Hairy silk, also known as R&D or ND, is produced by the hairy silkworm Phylosemia racini. It belongs to the phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Lepidoptera, family Saturnidae. The hairy silkworm is polyphagous in feeding habit and it feeds on the leaves of many number of food plants. Hairy silk is the product of the domesticated silkworm Phylosemia racini that feeds mainly on Ricinus communis, that is castor leaves. Hairy silk is called Ahimsa silk or also Vanya silk. Hairy silk production offers employment opportunities for castor plant growers and provides additional income with no significant additional investment. Hairy silkworm is the completely domesticated non-mulberry variety. It is a multi-voltine species, can be reared throughout the year where the climatic conditions are favorable. The cultural operations involved are easier and cheaper. Besides its resistance to diseases, it can stand little fluctuations in temperature and humidity. Agriculture is extended up to the altitude of 5000 feet and to the lowest level of the plains without any waterlogging in temperature varying from 55 degree to 98 degree Fahrenheit. In India, agriculture is mainly confined to the Brahmaputra Valley of northeastern states and North Kachar, Mikir Hills, Kamrup and Eastern Goilpara districts in Assam. It is also practiced in few districts of the neighboring states, mainly Meghalaya, Nagaland, Manipur and Arunachal Pradesh. Agriculture is practiced in North Tripura, Muzaffarpur, Bagalpur, Purulia districts in Bihar, Kuch Bihar, Jalpaiguri districts in West Bengal, Orissa, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Uttaranchal, Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. The hairy silkworm Phylosemia racini feeds primarily on castor, Ricinus communis. However, Kesaru, Heterophanous fragrans, is considered as another major perennial food plant. Besides these two, Eri silkworm being polyphagous in nature feeds on several alternative host plants like Evodia flaxinifolia, commonly known as Payam, Manihot utilis esculenta, commonly called as tapioca, Elianthus excelsa, commonly called as Bokkesaru, Elianthus grandis, called as Barpat, Plumeria artifolia, commonly called as Gulancha, Melina arborea, commonly called as Gamari, and many more. Rearing of Eri silkworms is simple and does not require high skill at any stage. Hence, sericulture is practiced traditionally by the tribals in the northeastern region as a subsidiary cottage industry. Sericulture is a household activity practiced mainly for protein-rich pupae, a delicacy for the tribal people. The cocoons are not reeled due to lot of discontinuity of thread, and therefore the moths are allowed to emerge out of the cocoon. Resultantly, the Eri cocoons are open mouth and do not have continuous filament, and hence they are spun. The Eri silk yarn is used indigenously for preparation of elegantly designed shawls and chadars, are quite popular for own use by the tribals because of their thermal properties. Eri silk spinning provides employment to rural poor. Recent development in design and product development have opened greater opportunities for Eri products in domestic and overseas markets. Harvesting of castor leaves up to 30 to 40% for rearing causes no loss in the field of castor seed, augmenting income from castor seed production and sericulture. The primary food plant of Eri silkworm, Resinus communis, that is castor plant. It is cultivated in most districts of Karnataka. The classification is order Malpighiales, family Euphorbiaceae, genus Resinus, and species communis. It is an evergreen bush or small tree, shoots and panicles glaucous, leaves green, 30 to 45 centimeter in diameter, membranous, lobes from oblong to linear acute, gland serrated, petiole 12 to 13 centimeter, racemose stout, erect, male flower 1.5 centimeter in diameter, female, calyx nearly oblong, styles often highly colored, capsules 1.5 to 3 centimeter long, globosely oblong, smooth seeds, oblong, smooth and mottled. Propagation technique of castor has been evolved and recommended to the field of raising systematic Eri food plantation at farmers level. Only sexual method is employed for propagation of Eri host plants. During sexual method of propagation is done through seeds. In castor, seeds are directly sown in the field for raising the plantation during March, April and September, October in northeastern India. Perennial varieties are recommended to be sown at a spacing of 1 into 1.5 meter spacing, while annual in 1 into 1 meter spacing. Both pit and furrow method of planting could be adopted for castor cultivation. The ideal period for plantation of castor plants is between March and April in northeastern region of India. September-October is another suitable season for raising castor. Castor is a warm season crop. However, it grows under diverse climatic conditions. In winter, its leaf yield gets considerably reduced. It is highly susceptible to waterlogging condition, and hence drainage is a must whenever low-lying area is selected for plantation. Flat and slopy soil, either acidic or alkaline, is suitable. Water stagnation is to be avoided by adopting proper drainage system in the planting area. However, humus and sandy soil suits for luxurious growth of the plant. There are several varieties of castor available in India. A non-bloomy red variety of castor, NBR1, local green, local pink, 48-1 varieties of castor showed better performance in leaf yield and silkworm rearing in northeastern India. 10 promising cashew varieties have been identified suitable for airy silkworm rearing. They are local green, damalgiri, T3, local red, non-powdery, etc. High-yielding varieties of castor have the potentiality of producing 10 to 12 ton leaf per hectare per year. In addition, it could also produce 2 to 4 quintals of seeds per hectare in a year. Under northeastern condition, from castor plantation, 4 leaf harvest can be made in a year during May, July, August, October, November and February, March. NBR 1 variety of castor with recommended package of practices ensures 12 metric tons of leaf yield per hectare as against 8 metric tons yield at farmer's level, which amounts to 33.3% gain. Land should be plowed 2 to 3 times to a depth of 20 to 25 centimeter and leveled for facilitating good root penetration and easy weeding. Pit system of plantation is followed for raising castor for airy silkworm rearing. For sowing the seeds, 20 into 25 into 25 centimeter size pits are to be prepared, maintaining 1 into 1 meter spacing. In each pit, 1 kg farmyard manure along with urea 13 gram, SSP 25 gram and MOP 3 gram are to be added as basal dose and is covered with soil. Mature capsules of seeds are to be collected during sunny day. Capsules are to be sun-dried well and seeds to be removed. Before sowing the seeds, it is necessary to treat the matured and healthy seeds with bavastin 2 gram per kg to check seed borne diseases. 2 seeds per pit at a depth of 2.5 to 3 centimeter are to be sown. Germination takes place after 7 to 10 days. Only 1 healthy seedling per pit has to be allowed for vigorous growth after germination. In addition to organic manure, chemical fertilizers is also important for better growth and leaf yield in castor. Chemical fertilizer NPK at the rate of 60:40:20 kg per hectare is recommended in first dose of fertilizer as basal dose at pit, and second dose 30 kg nitrogen per hectare should be applied after attaining the age of 3 months. A large number of undesirable weeds absorb nutrients and moisture of soil, resulting stunted growth of castor. Regular weeding helps for luxuriant growth of castor. Besides plowing, hoeing, weeding, etc. are to be carried out timely after and before application of fertilizer for healthy growth and leaf yield. 4 leaf harvests are being made in northeastern region from a single plant in a year during May, June, July, August, September, October, November, January and February and April. Tapioca is a perennial shrub with variously branched stem growing to a height of 3 to 4 meters and products enlarged tuberous roots. It grows best in warm and humid climate. Soils of all types except in saline or alkaline having pH within 5.5 to 7 but could not withstand waterlogging. The leaves of this plant are very large with long petioles having 5 to 10 lobes or sometimes more. Dark green in color, but red, yellow and purple color leaves are also found. Tapioca plants are propagated through cuttings. Stems of 8 to 10 months old with a diameter of 2 to 3 centimeter are selected for preparation of cuttings. Discarding the upper immature and lower mature base, the stem is cut into pieces of 20 centimeter which are used as planting material. Study conducted revealed that with the increase in spacing, the plant produces more number of branches. Maximum leaf yield recorded per acre is 10,250 kg in 30 centimeter spacing, followed by 60 centimeter 7,846 kg. Poyam is a lofty forest tree with lusty growth. A tree native to the Himalayas reaching a maximum size of 50 feet with a trunk diameter of 1 foot. Evergreen perennial tree which prefers to grow on the slopy hills. the plant has shallow root system and hence the tree is easily swept away by the strong wind. Leaves are pinnately compound, imperipinnate and stipulate. The leaves reach a maximum length of 27 inches and are composed of up to 11 leaflets in 14 into 3.5 inches in size. The mature capsules are red, usually 4. Seeds rather compressed, weighing 9 to 10 milligram, testa dark brown to blackish in color. The albumen and cotyledons are oily. The plant is commonly grown from seedlings. Air layering is also practiced for vegetative propagation. The mature seeds are collected during September-October and sown immediately to get maximum germination. Due to absence of an ideal propagation technique, plantation of payam could not be taken up at farmer's level and therefore it is found as stray plantation in some pockets of this region. In Nagaland and Meghalaya, payam is used as major food plant for airy silkworm rearing as it is evergreen in nature. After 2 years of plantation, the plants are pruned to get a thick crown at a manageable height. The normal gestation period is 3 to 4 years and layers can be harvested 4 times in a year. The leaf yield per acre of plantation was estimated up to the tune of 10,125 kg per year.